We're working on chapter 2, lesson 5, percent of change. A percent of change is a ratio that compares the change in quantity to the original amount. Okay, when I think of change, just like when we talked about rate of change, and when we talked about ratios, change is when you subtract. When you find slope, you find a change. So I have percent of change equals amount of change over the original amount. So when you compare the amount of change to the original amount in a ratio, you are finding the percent of change. Percent of change is based on the original amount. If the original quantity is increased, then it is called a percent of increase. If the original quantity is decreased, then it's called a percent of decrease. So the percent of increase is just the amount of increase over the original amount. Percent of decrease is the amount of decrease over the original amount. So for our first example, it says find the percent of change in the cost of gasoline from 1970 to 2010. Round to the nearest whole percent if necessary. Since the 2010 price is greater than the 1970 price, this is a percent of increase. Because you go from what you started to what it becomes. So it started at a lower amount, and so it went to a higher amount, so that means it's increasing. So we need to find the amount of increase. So you just take the higher number, $2.95 minus $1.30, and you get the difference of $1.65. Then you find the percent of increase. So the percent of increase is the amount of the increase, which was $1.65. Over the original amount. The original amount is what you started. It's always what is first, so that was $1.30. So I take $1.65 over $1.30. And when I put that in my calculator, I get about 1.27, but then that is not a percent. You always have to move your decimal place then to the right, and it went up 127%. So the cost of gasoline increased by 127% from 1970 to 2010. Example 2 says Yusuf bought a DVD recorder for $280. Now it is on sale. Okay, so if it's on sale, is that going to be an increase or a decrease? Should be a decrease, right? If it's on sale, they're going to decrease the amount for $220. So if I went from 280 to 220, I started high and I went low. Find the percent of change in the price. Round to the nearest whole percent if necessary. So the nearest whole number. Since the new price is less than the original price, this is a percent of decrease. So you first find the amount of decrease. So I just take 280 minus 220, get $60. Then to find it the percent, you put it over the original amount. The original amount was 280. So then I take my $60 over $280. Put it in my calculator and I get 0.21, which then I move my decimal place two places to the right and I get 21%. Take a second and try to do A. It says find the percent of change from 10 yards to 13 yards. Okay, I'm starting at 10 and I'm going up to 13. So is this going to be an increase or a decrease? It's going to be an increase. So I just find my amount of change first. So I take 13 minus 10 and I put that over my original starting number, which would be 10. So then I'm going to put 10 on the bottom. So 13 minus 10 is 3, and it's 3 over 10. Put that in your calculator. You should be able to know how to write 3 tenths. It's written as 3 tenths. But then I need to write it as a percent. So I move my decimal place two places to the right, and my answer is 30%. Pause the video again and try B on your own. The price of a radio was $20, so that's what it started with. It is on sale for $15. So did my price increase or did it decrease? It decreased from 20, because it went down to 15. So what is the percent of change in the price of a radio? So I start with my original amount or my bigger amount. So I've got 20 minus 15 over the original price of the radio is $20. So then I have 5 over 20. So then I take 5 divided by 20 in your calculator and you get 0.25. But that's not a percent. So I move the decimal place 2 places to the right and now I have 25%. The other thing with working with percent of change, you can have a percent of error. Error is when how you went wrong, what you did wrong with something. So then it says the percent of error is a ratio that compares the inaccuracy of an estimate or amount of error to the actual amount. So percent error is your amount of error over the actual thing that it was, not what you guessed what it actually is. So it says finding the percent of error is similar to finding percent of change. Instead of finding the amount of increase or decrease, you find the amount an estimate is greater or less than the actual amount. So suppose you guess there are 300 gumballs in a jar, but there are actually 400. So I find my difference. So I take 400 minus 300, because that's what I was wrong, over the actual amount. It says they're actually 400. So 400 would be on the bottom. So then 400 minus 300 is 100 over 400. Which when I put it in my calculator, you get 0.25. Then you move your decimal place 2 places to the right, and I was off 25%. So it's how much error I had over the actual. You want the actual amount. Example 3. Ahind wants to practice free throws. He estimates the distance from the free throw line to the hoop and marks it with a chalk. Ahmed's estimate was 13.5 feet. The actual, I'm going to put a box around that word actual, distance should be 15 feet. Find the percent error. So I start with 15 minus 13.5 and I put that over my actual amount, which is 15. So then in my calculator, I take 15 minus 13.5, which is 1.5. So that's my error. I put it over the actual amount, which is 15. So then I put that in my calculator and I get 0.1. That's a decimal. We need percents. So I move the decimal 2 places to the right and I get 10%. So my percent error is 10%. Pause the video, please, and go ahead and try to do C. So it says to find the percent error, if the estimate, okay, that's my estimate, and the actual, I'm going to put a box around that, amount is 245, round to the nearest whole percent. So I take 245 minus 230, put it over my actual. Was my 230 my actual or my 245? The 245. So then I have 15 over 245. 15 divided by 245 is 0.061. We round to the nearest whole percent, so I move it over 2 places. It's really just going to be 6%. I'm just going to quickly set these next problems up so you can come back and get a few more examples. It says find the percent of change. Round to the nearest whole percent if necessary. So remember, when you're doing percent of change, it's your percent over the original amount. So it was 30 inches to 24. So I take 30 minus 24 and I put that over my original amount, which is 30. So then I would have 6 over 30. Put that in your calculator. I get 0.2, but then I need to move the decimal place two places and I get 20%. 126 to 150. Take 150 minus 126 over my original amount, which is 126. So 150 minus 126 is 24 over my original amount, which is 126. 24 divided by 126 is 0.190. Move your decimal place two places to the right. And it increased 19%. Jessie estimates the weight of her cat to be 10 pounds. The actual, I'm going to put a box around the actual weight of the cat, is 13.75 pounds. Find the percent error. So I'm going to take 13.75, the actual minus the minus the 10 equals over my actual 13.75. So then I have 3.75 over 13.75. And I get 0.2727, but then I move the decimal place two places to right and I get 27%. Go to Canvas, after you've written all these notes, look at the problems that you were supposed to complete for today. It would be the independent practice. Make sure you are showing your work. You're setting it up. You may use your calculator, but you're showing the subtraction over the division. And we will go over your work tomorrow.